Hi everyone, my name is Jake and today I'd like to share tool tips and tricks on adding two-page spreads to your comics. This video will cover tips and advice on setting up, tips on application, and tips on exporting, all of which can be accomplished in Clip Studio Paint. For other videos and tutorials on the topic, check out the links in the description. So what is a two-page spread? A two-page spread, or a double-page spread, is two pages treated as one in a publication, with the art and text extended across the binding. The two-page spread is a unique application to any comics and might require you to ask yourself, how do I intend to publish? Will this work online? Do I know where best to use a spread in my story? Between a spread and a single page, a two-page spread can be more visually interesting and engaging, but it may be better off for print. A single page is universally applicable and good for both print and web, but lacks the same oomph of a spread. You can create comic pages in both versions of Clip Studio Paint, but the way you set up two-page spreads are done differently. If you've upgraded to Clip Studio Paint EX, you're given the tools to manage multiple pages at once and to even combine them together. You can do this by right-clicking on a page and going down to Combine Pages. Click OK on the pop-up, and your pages will merge into a single file. This action is reversible by right-clicking on Merge Pages and selecting Split Pages. If you have Pro, you may just need to do a little finagling to get a double page spread going with the dimensions you're looking for. You can find free dimension templates in the asset store for double page spreads, such as PixelPenguin's Manga printing dimensions, or find the dimension templates you need available free online. Next, let's talk about applying them to your comic. Two page spreads can create a stronger impact than a single page. You can utilize just about any significant beat in your story in your spread. You can use them in slow pace or fast pace, use them to put your splash pages, expositions, scenery, or group shots, use them for heavy action, big reveals, and your climax. Basically, two-page spreads are the most labor-intensive money shots in your comic, and learning how to execute them effectively is a skill in its own. Study up from masters like J.H. Williams III, Pablo Rivera, Eddie Barrows, Tsukasa Hojo, and Jim Lee to start getting your ideas. For any spreads, however, here are two tips on how to put them on your pages. First, avoid putting any action in the very middle. Where the split happens is where the print binding is. If you ever intend to print your comic, putting anything on or near the middle will risk being lost in the fold. Simply avoid drawing any important parts here, such as action, dialogue, or the middle of panels. Next tip is that you still need to consider the composition. Your canvas is now twice the size of a normal page, and the direction your art reads is more crucial than ever. Keep the key action sequence, flow of movement, and dialogue going from left to right, including any inset panels you involve. What helps me is to find templates that let me visualize the movement before I even start sketching, many of which can be found in the asset store. I highly recommend Shehaub's Gold Section Major and Minor material based on the Fibonacci ratio, and even s-nao's Golden Ratio / Silver Ratio vector template to get a good idea of ideal spaces to insert your focus points and flow. Finally, we're going to talk about exporting. When you usually export your comic pages, the dimensions are uniform across the board. For single pages, they are all the same size. However, spreads are exported a little differently. Because they are 2-in-1, the size is twice as wide as a single page, but the height will remain the same. To do this in EX, simply export your comic in a batch through File, Export Multiple Pages, Batch Export. In the batch pop-up, uncheck Split Spread Pages. Unless printing requirements state otherwise, we will always want to keep the spread pages together in its own file. When you're deciding on dimensions, it will show only the option for the standard page, but this affects spreads too. Between spreads and solo pages, the height will always remain the same, and batch exporting will always match the size of your spreads to the dimensions of the rest of your pages. Then you export, and you should be good to go. If you're using Pro, the idea is still the same. When you export your spreads, make sure that the height dimension remains the same as your single page exports, and you'll be golden. What's really wonderful about Clip Studio is that all these tools are available by default, and there's a large library of tools made by users for users, all available in the Clip Studio Asset Store. Although I believe ultimately the tools don't make the artist, Clip Studio makes the comic creating process incredibly streamlined and user-friendly for beginners and masters alike. I hope you found this video helpful, and I wish you luck on your comic journey. Thank you for watching, and until next time.